Hey there, folks. This is Deeksha Janiani representing Team Trendline. And this week, we discuss the succession planning that is underway at Reliance Industries. We will also talk about how the business of Reliance Industries transformed in the last 5 years. Further on, we'll be discussing the challenges that await the new scions in making. So, twin siblings Akash and Isha Ambani, who are the children of Mukesh and Neeta Ambani, formally joined Reliance Industries back in 2014. Fast forward to 2019, both got elevated on the board as directors of Jio Platforms and Reliance Retail Ventures. The youngest son of Mukesh Ambani, who is Anant Ambani, joined as a director on the board of Jio Platforms in March 2020 and on the board of Reliance Retail Ventures in March 2022. So in the current turn of events, Mukesh Ambani stepped down as the chairman of Reliance Jio Infocom, while his son Akash Ambani took over as the new chairman. However, Mukesh Ambani continues to be the chairman of Jio Platforms and of course Reliance Industries. So Jio Platforms also houses other digital investments in startups like Savan and Mvibe, apart from the main telecommunications business. So this succession is in line with Mukesh Ambani's plan to pass on the baton to the younger generation. This is something which he had already hinted at in the annual general meeting of 2021. And if news reports are to be believed, Isha Ambani might also be soon elevated to the position of chairman at Reliance Retail. Another key point to note here is that the Ambani family holds an equity stake of 50.66% in Reliance Industries through various firms. So they clearly have the majority. So while Reliance Industries is becoming the poster boy of succession planning in family-led firms in India, there are also other key successions that took place in 2022. So Sudarshan Venu, who's the son of Chairman Emeritus Venu Srinivasan, was elevated to the position of Managing Director at TVS Motors from being a joint Managing Director. So this is, you know, a very typical trend in Indian families when children are trained to become CEOs by becoming joint MDs first. So in another key development, Harsh Agarwal and Mohan Goenka, who are the children of RS Agarwal and RS Goenka, became the vice chairman of Emami, which is a major FMCG player. On the other hand, Nayaka Holkar, who's the niece of Jamshed and Godrej, will be soon taking over as the chairman of Godrej and Boys. Folks, this is a flagship company of Godrej Group and also holds stakes in listed Indian companies like Godrej Consumer Products and Godrej Properties. So, folks, there is an innate fact, you know, a belief in our Indian families that the positions of power and responsibility and wealth should remain within the same family and in fact be passed on across several generations. And, you know, surname matters here more than your, you know, competence. So many non-family members and management do feel left out in such a system because the final signing authority always lies with the founding family. And instead of the same being based on merit. And that also explains why even today, 57% of companies within Nifty 50 are controlled by Indian business families. Yes, that is right. So let's find out who all are being groomed to take over the bigger positions in the future. So Karan Adani is currently the CEO of Adani Ports and SEZ. He's also the CEO of Adani Airport Holdings. Jay Kotak, who is the son of Uday Kotak, is co-heading the digital-only initiative at Kotak Mahindra Bank, namely Kotak 811. And this trend is also being observed for recently listed startups like Nykaa, which is led by Falguni Nair. Her daughter, Advaita Nair, is heading the fashion division at Nykaa, while her son, Anchit Nair, is heading the beauty and e-commerce division at Nykaa. So yes, that's right. So Mukesh Ambani, who's all of 65 years, is intent to pass on the responsibilities onto their children. And this might be driven by some bitter experiences that he had in the past. So Dhirubhai Ambani, who is the founder of Reliance Industries, had died back in 2002 interstate. Means he did not leave a will behind. So this caused a three-year-long ownership tussle between his sons, Anil Ambani and Mukesh Ambani. And when this issue came out in the open in November 2004, the share price of Reliance Industry fell a whopping 12% in a span of just 1 month. And then, you know, in true Bollywood style, their mother, Kokilaben Ambani, had to intervene and finally drive the division of assets between them. So Mukesh Ambani got the petrochemical and refining business, and Anil Ambani got the new emerging businesses. So back then, folks, the market capitalization of Reliance used to be around 84,000 crores, which has now leapfrogged to over 16 lakh crores. So this is not a company which is small in any size. It's of a massive size, and it has varied business interests, which makes this succession planning even more critical now than it ever was. So moving on, let's see how Reliance has performed vis-a-vis other, you know, family-controlled conglomerates in India. So see, what we have done is to estimate the aggregate market cap, we have taken the top five companies in each of the groups except Tata. For Tata, we have taken the top 10 companies by market capitalization. Here, we have also excluded the holding companies except for Grasim. So as per these estimations, Murugappa Group and Bajaj Group stand out. So Cholamandalam Investment and Finance Company, Tube Investments of India, drove the stellar returns that Murugappa Group has generated in the last 9 years. And it was Bajaj Finance, hands down, which led the 8x rise in the market cap of Bajaj Group in the last 9 years. And folks, Reliance is also not far behind, because it also generated 20% plus returns for the shareholders in last 9 years. However, its earnings growth has been 13% only in the last 9 years. So somewhere its valuations have gone ahead of the net profit growth that it actually clocked on the ground. So, you know, its emerging businesses and the investment of over 5 lakh crore that it is committing to new energy initiatives might have, might have a role to play in its higher valuations here. So, folks, now let us understand how Reliance Industries has evolved in the last 5 years. So, its revenues were predominantly driven by petrochemical and refining segments, which now are called the oil to chemical segment. Even now, this segment contributes a lion's share to its revenues, but there are other segments of like Reliance Jio particularly, which have become prominent now. In fact, the consumer facing businesses of Reliance, namely Reliance Retail and Reliance Jio, now contribute over 40% to the company's EBITDA in FY22. And the contribution of its legacy business is down to 57% in FY22 from 80% in FY18. So now let us see how Reliance Jio has done. So Reliance Jio has seen a stellar rise in its revenues. Its revenues have grown over 4 times between FY18 and FY22. And that is on the back of a very healthy momentum in subscriber addition and also a decent growth in average revenue per user. Folks, there were many foreign investors like Facebook, Google, KKR, Texas Pacific Group, which were interested in this business back in FY21. In fact, they invested over 1.5 lakh crore in this business. And Deeksha Janiani and Akash Ambani were, you know, part of the negotiating teams which cracked these deals. And ultimately, these deals led to the debt reduction for the company and also unlocked its value. Yes, that's right. And folks, Reliance Retail division is also not far behind. It also saw its revenues grow nearly 3x in, you know, between FY18 and FY22. And that is on account of the, you know, doubling of the store count, which is over 15,000 right now. And this business basically has sub-segments like grocery, it has fashion and lifestyle, it has consumer electronics. And Deeksha Janiani, who's the current director at this company, was instrumental in structuring this business as a house of brands by basically acquiring, popular labels like Ritu Kumar, Abu Jani and Sandeep Khosla, brands like Just Dial and NetMeds, Hamleys, among others. So now, you know, we should now let us understand what are the challenges that await Akash in Deeksha. So the next big thing for Reliance Jio is the 5G spectrum auction that will take place on July 26th and onwards. So Akash basically has to plan the network, he has to choose the right vendors, and he has to basically enable a successful rollout of this network in the country. And this is very critical because the company will be incurring a considerable capex on this auction over the course of next 20 years. And the challenge for Deeksha is also ready. So she has to achieve the, you know, vision of Mukesh Ambani to make the retail business as amongst the top 10 retail businesses globally. So, according to a Deloitte report published in 2022, Reliance Retail stood at the 56th position amongst the global retailers. The top 10th retailer was Target Corporation, which clocked revenues of over 7.3 lakh crore. So Reliance Retail has to grow its revenues over four times to actually reach that position. So task for Isha is clearly cut out for her. So the next, all eyes are now on the next annual general meeting of Reliance Industries, which will take place in 2022, because there we'll come to know about the new growth targets that are set for Jio and retail, and you know, guidance for the new energy business. And we will, you know, also know if there is a possibility of listing of, you know, Jio platforms, and some color on the final succession plan of Mukesh Ambani. So this was my time, folks. Thank you so very much, and have a great day.